the summer.
I am trying to tell you, it appears to be stuck. I am being choked by the rocketeer's speed.
Underground railways are without doubt a menace to health.
On the contrary, my dear sir, I think you'll find that the steam from a locomotive, far from being detrimental to your health, is actually extremely beneficial.
I can hardly believe in fact, my dear fellow. The health giving effects of the Southeast is very long. That it acts nearly as a disinfectant.
Well, that's all very interesting, I'm sure. I'm still being slowly asphyxiated.
Would you ask me?
No, what will come of
underground?
I just think it's only three stops from Baker Street.
Don't worry, dear. My treat.
Oh, no, Dorothy. We'll go down.
Edward's promotion came through last month. He's assistant manager now.
Well,
Celia, I insist.
Oh, thank you. Of course, Dennis heads his own section. I must say, Dorothy, I'm so glad.
Thank you.
The apprentice, James Greathead, the final concept and created a demonstration model to convince new investors.
Mr. Greathead, my father almost lost his fortune on Brunel's financial calamity. Why would I now invest in your tunnel?
Because, sir, my tubular device pushes more readily into the soft clay of London while simultaneously shielding the mine.
With the opening of the town subway in 1870, the principle of the Great Head Shield was a proven success. The standard of the next year would not appear until 1890, and 20 years later, giving great pleasure to collect the Shield.
The life would be that, right?
Thank you. no entry.
No. If you see that.
Billy Grail.
Sorry, mate. No problem.
Right.
Thanks.
by the entrance. Thank you. Come on.